these all originate in spaces. So this idea starts to propagate and we start inventing physical spaces. So chambers, halls, rooms, plates, and springs. So Bill Putnam invented the chamber reverb. So here's one of the most famous acoustic spaces is one of the echo chambers at Capitol Studios in Los Angeles. So this is a door. These are speakers. Each one of these are speakers. You can see a microphone here, and then this cable is leading to the other microphone. So we got super reflective walls. The sound that you want to put in the chamber is played through here, just like Bill Putnam did in 1947. So the sound of a harmonica or a snare is played through these loudspeakers, bounces around the space, and then picked up by the microphone. So depending where you put the microphones, generally these spaces have kind of pieces of tape for different things. So smaller sounds or bigger sounds. And that's a chamber reverb. All right, so we're simulating the acoustic environment and we can dictate what goes through there. Do we want to put cymbals or the kick drum or the electric guitar or the voice? And we can do that and blend that in with the dry signal. So on the console, we use an aux send to send the dry signal to a loudspeaker. That would then create a sound and amplify around the room and would reflect all the different surfaces picked up by microphone. We could change the sound of this room by placing this closer or farther away, changing the pattern of the microphone, where we face the microphone. We get those reflected sounds. And then this is the wet signal, which is sent back and then on the console combined with the dry signal to give you that simulated acoustic environment. So that's pretty cool. That's a chamber reverb.
Now the party's over, I'm so tired. Then I see you coming out of nowhere. Much communication.
Definitely a chamber reverb, right? So real dense, but we don't hear like a lot of scattering, and it's and then it kind of disappears, right? It happens and then it doesn't linger on forever. So that's a really good example of a chamber reverb. This is a famous example of a stairwell, which I would call a type of a chamber. So you heavily compress the room mics on that chamber and you get that sound. So a hall, when you see that, that's emulating a concert hall. Again, you know, as long as we've been performing live, there have been opera halls and concert halls. So the acoustic of this were known. And the idea is the reverb happens, but it's behind the original sound. So you get the direct sound of the violin player or the opera singer, and then the sound bounces around and then combines a little bit later, but you get that initial sound and it kind of lingers behind there. So halls are a very natural sounding reverbs. So small hall, large hall, vocal hall, right? You'll see those labeled and now you're, okay, so that's what we're not talking about, a hallway, but a hall reverb. Bill Putnam put a speaker in the room, right? So simulating the sound of a room. So now we're going to have instead of RTC of like 15 seconds or less, we're now in the 1 to 2 second range with our RT60. So we've got tiled walls, tiled floor. We're going to get a lot of initial reflections and not much decay. So it's really useful for giving oomph to a sound, for giving some sparkle, but not sounding like it's a ballad, right? You're not gonna hear these big lush decays like you do in that Sophia Hagia temple. You're just gonna get these a lot of early reflections.
I'm coming down with it.
So here is a band, sounds exactly like they're playing in a room, which they are. I'm going to play this because it also happens to be one of my favorite all-time bass tones, by the way. So there's clearly ambience around the drums, right? It doesn't sound like our ears right on the snare drum or the kick drum.